Welcome children, take up your history book, chapter 7, The Great Uprising. Today I am going to explain page 70, 71 and 72 in gist. The British became the supreme power of India by the mid 18th century. By that time, most of the Indian territory went under the direct control of the British administration, while some areas remained under indirect control of the British. The last Mughal Emperor Bahadur Shah Zafar was the emperor only in name. He had neither territory nor power. Almost all sections of the Indian society were unhappy with the British rule. The rulers were offended for the annexation of their territories. Noblemen were angered by the loss of their jamindaris. The peasants hated the exploitative method system of revenue collection. The tribal feared a threat to their livelihoods. The craftsmen were against the new economic policy. The sepoys were treated unfairly by the British officers. Different sections of the society showed their anger through protest and revolt. But these protests were largely localized and the British easily suppressed them. Causes of uprising. In 1857, whole Indian society went against the British rule. The main causes were economic causes. Economic exploitation was the main cause that angered the people, which affected all sections of society. Peasants had to pay high land revenue. Even if the crops failed in such a situation, they had to borrow money from the moneylender. Once failed to repay the loan, their land were taken away. This made their life miserable. Indian craftsmen and artisans couldn't compete with the British machine-made goods, which were cheaper to produce. People preferred to buy machine-made goods as they were cheaper, and this ruined the traditional Indian industries. Priests, poets and musicians lost their source of livelihood due to the withdrawal of royal patronage. Political causes. The ruling classes were losing their territories due to the British annexation policy. All Mughal territories were captured by the British. The rulers lost their independence, who accepted the terms of subsidiary alliance. The policy of the doctrine of lapse turned Rani Lakshmibai go against the British. Awadh. In 1856, when Lord Dalhousie annexed Awadh, people went against the British, as the Nawab of Awadh had always been loyal to the British. People took it as a betrayal. It even hurt the sentiments of the sepoys, as most of them belonged from Awadh and the surrounding area. Social causes. The British passed some laws like banning of sati, legalizing widow remarriage and encouraging Western education. These were taken as negative view by some Indian society, as they believed that it was an interference with the country's social custom. Indians were not allowed to travel in the first class compartments in train. This social discrimination of racial superiority angered the Indians. Educated Indians went against the British, as they were denied promotions and opportunity to be appointed to high posts. And with this, I am ending my today's class. Goodbye.